Great morning, my dear friends. Bhupesh Anand. So we are starting with the new lecture number 3. We have covered 2 lectures in international trade and capital flows. The most important reading, you know, the most testable reading for your examination, CFA examination, level 1 examination. So today we'll be starting with that, learning outcome number C, that what is the difference between absolute advantage and comparative advantage, highly testable in examination. So please be attentive, be patient, and be 100%, put your 100% today, because it has some tricks, you know, how to calculate relative advantage. So that I am telling you, but please write down international trade and capital flows. It means trade between one country to another country flowing. The goods are imported and exported. Now the point is which country should produce which, then only we can have economic welfare. And today's lecture is on that only, because in the last lecture we discussed about cost and benefits of international trade flows. That there will be more employment, the cost will reduce. Now the point is which country should produce which product, then only that cost will be decreased, you know. And for that we are today that comparing, calculating absolute advantage and comparative advantage. So please take out your registers. Great morning, international trade and capital flows, lecture number 3. So today I am going to start with, I am going to deliver with lecture number 3, learning outcome number C, distinguish between comparative and absolute advantage. Very simple concept. Absolute advantage is very simple, that which product should be produced by which country, because I cannot do all the things. I cannot manage my tax returns. I cannot go for costing returns. I can only go for finance, you know. So I should do what I am better in, you know. So I want to find out that which village or which country should produce oranges and which should produce apples. No doubt that country can produce apples and oranges both, but because of the quality of that soil, it is better that they will produce oranges, because the production of oranges is more in per hectare. Similarly, if I compare per hectare of another country production, so I can, you know, with help of resources, with help of production and units, I can decide that which product should be produced by which country. So first point I'm going to start with is, what is the meaning of absolute advantage? When I say absolute advantage, it is prima facie I can see that which country has the absolute advantage over which product. So please write an absolute advantage. A country is said to have an absolute advantage in the production of goods. If it can produce the goods at a lower cost in terms of resources relative to another country. Very simple. Please write it down. I will explain it. No need to worry. Absolute advantage. A country is said to have an absolute advantage. A country is said to have an absolute advantage in the production of goods. A country is said to have an absolute advantage in the production of goods if it can produce the goods at a lower cost in terms of resources in relation to another country. So I will see through that. I will be explaining it with the help of example. No need to worry. I have not explained anything. Just write it down and then write it down. What is the meaning of comparative advantage? And then with the help of so many case studies, I will be telling you what is the difference between absolute and what is the difference between comparative. How to calculate absolute and how to calculate comparative. Comparative advantage. A country is said to have a comparative advantage in the production of goods if its opportunity cost. I can file income tax returns and I can go for register ROC work also. But I can do more efficiently income tax return, I can, as compared to ROC. So I should put my 100% in filing income tax return, and that ROC work should be outsourced. So that something is named as comparative advantage. A person cannot do all the things. Now we have to see that if I am doing this and if I am not doing that, what is the opportunity cost for that? So a country is said to have a comparative advantage in the production of goods if its opportunity cost in terms of other goods. If its opportunity cost in terms of other goods that could be produced. I repeat, a country is said to have a comparative advantage in the production of goods if its opportunity cost in terms of other goods that could be produced instead is lower than that of another country. I know that you are not getting it, but still, because we have to write down the definition and then I will, with the help of case study, I can explain it. A country is said to have a comparative advantage in the production of goods if its opportunity cost in terms of other goods that could be produced instead is lower than that of another country. So leave it. I am just, with the help of case studies, I will be telling you what I mean by absolute advantage and what I mean by comparative advantage. First three case studies I will be giving you today. First case study A, just see the information. Suppose there are two countries, country A and country B, and country A can produce the same product with per day at this much cost, resource cost, and country B can produce the same product per day at this much cost. Now we have to see that, you know, which country has an absolute advantage. For example, a country A can produce X unit, can produce the same product, let it be star, at by using X unit of resource. But the same product with the same unit, country Y, country B can produce at X plus something cost, resource. It means country B is producing at a costlier affair. It is producing at a higher cost. So in that case, I can prima facie say that country A has an absolute advantage in producing product number star. Even though you are not getting it, no problem. I am coming to firstly to case study B because it has a better number, you know. You can better understand that. Suppose country A and country B can produce two types of products. Now be sincere for coming 2-3 minutes. I am telling you, it will change your life. This question is highly testable. This type of questions are highly testable. So please be attentive. So I am taking case study number B. Suppose country A and country B can produce two types of products. They can produce chocolates or they can produce cheese. Either chocolates or cheese per day. I have given you the number of units they can produce. Country A can produce 10 chocolates in one day. And country B can produce 12 chocolates in one day. It means one day is the resource. In one day, country A can produce 10 chocolates and country B can produce 12 chocolates. Or either they can produce, you know, or they can go for cheese also. Or they can produce cheese. Country A can produce 5 units of cheese in a day. And country B can produce 5.5 units of cheese in a day. So the point is, listen to me. The question is, either they can produce chocolates or they can produce cheese in a day. Now you have to firstly find out which country has an absolute advantage over which product. Now it is prima facie, you know, this absolute advantage can be easily calculated on the basis of prima facie. Just see, 10 units of chocolates are being produced in one day by country A and 12 units of chocolate are being produced by country B. So I can say that country B has an absolute advantage in producing chocolates as compared to country A. Because in one day, they can only produce 10 units, but country B people can produce 12 units. It means country B has an absolute advantage over production of chocolates. Now if I compare cheese, country A can produce in one day 5 units of cheese, but they can produce 5.5 units of cheese in one day. It means country B has an absolute advantage over cheese also. So the point is, absolute advantage can easily be compared by seeing the numbers, you know, the units produced. With the same resource, how many units they are producing and how many units they are producing. With the same resource, how many units have been produced by this person and this person. We can directly compare it and we can directly comment it that this is the absolute advantage. But in order to calculate comparative advantage, there is a trick behind that. So please write down firstly what I have just spoken now. Just have a look, you know. Now in order to comment on absolute and comparative advantage, in order to comment on absolute and comparative advantage, following is important. Country B can produce more number of chocolates in a day as compared to country A. Similarly, so we can conclude that country B has an absolute advantage over country B in respect to production of chocolates. Similarly, we can, you know, country B can also produce more units of cheese in a day as compared to country A. So I can say, we can conclude that country B is enjoying absolute advantage in cheese as well. Now, absolute advantage is easy. Now, how to calculate comparative advantage? In this, we have to find out the opportunity cost. That if country A is producing chocolates and not producing cheese, or producing cheese in respect to chocolate, so what is the opportunity cost behind that? That is somewhat tricky. So I have prepared a note for that. In order to calculate relative advantage, comparative advantage, we have to calculate per unit opportunity cost. So for example, country B in one day can either produce 12 chocolates or can produce 5.5 units of cheese. That is okay. It means for 5.5 units of cheese or 12 units of this, it means for 1 unit of cheese, how many chocolates they are compensating? That is 12 upon 5.5, that comes to 1.2. It means either they can produce 1 unit of cheese or they can produce 1.2 units of chocolates. So that same thing I have written, for 1 unit of cheese or 2.1 units of chocolate. Similarly, we will compare for country A that they can produce 10 units of, you know, chocolates and 5 units of cheese. So for one unit of cheese, they can either produce 1 unit of cheese or they can produce 2 units of chocolates. So the point is, which country has to do what? Now this is the main point, you know. Now, again, I am repeating, just see, in order to calculate the comparative advantage, we have to compare the products being produced by the same country. And it is very simple that either they can produce 12 units of chocolates or they can produce 5.5 units of cheese. So I have calculated the opportunity cost for 1 unit of cheese, 2.1 units of chocolates are equal. Similarly, for 1 unit of this cheese, 2 units of chocolate are equal. So the point is this country A and country B. Now see the implication. It implies country A is producing cheese at a relatively lesser cost than chocolates. Just see. Country A is only producing cheese by compensating not doing 2 units of chocolates. But if country B will produce cheese, then they will be compensating 2.1 units of chocolates. It means country A has a comparative advantage. Country A has a comparative advantage in producing cheese, you know, because the opportunity cost in that is less, at a relatively lesser cost than chocolates. So it means country A should produce cheese and country B should produce chocolates. Or I can say country B has a comparative advantage in producing chocolates and country A has a comparative advantage in producing cheese. I know that you are not 100% got, no problems. We will starting with the next case study. And this case study will give you a more enlightenment. Just have a look on this. I have directly coming with the numbers, cloth cost. In this case study, I have not given you the numbers. Rather, I have given you that this is a cost in dollars. If England produces cloth, you know, this is the cost. They have to incur $100. And if England produces wine, then this is $110 is the cost which they have to incur for 1 unit, I will say, 1 unit and for 1 unit. And if Portugal country produces, you know, cloth, then they have to incur $90 and $80 in case of wine. Now the first point which I want to tell you, if I want to calculate absolute advantage or comparative advantage, if I am not given the numbers, you know, firstly I have to convert that into numbers, because I can only compare the numbers with the help of numbers. It becomes easy to find out whose absolute advantage which country has. So because the cost is given to me. So I have to assume some cost that in per day, I am incurring only $500. So I can calculate the numbers, you know. If 100 is a dollar, $100 is for one unit, then $500 can be spent, then I can produce 5 units of cloth. England can produce 5 units of cloth. Or if I see for Portuguese, 500 upon 90. So we can calculate this also. So I have done it like this. Please write down this explanation. This will be helping you a lot. Firstly, in order to calculate advantage, the given information should be in numbers. As cost has been specified, so I have to convert into numbers. So I will be assuming one limited cost, that this is a cost which I can incur per day. So I have assumed that cost as $500. And then I have converted into numbers that if England wants to produce, you know, England can produce 5 units of cloth or 4.54 units of wine, and Portuguese can go for 5.55 units of cloth or 6.25 units of wine. So if I see prima facie, you know, I can say that Portuguese has the advantage over England in respect of cloth as well as in respect of wine, because they can produce more numbers as compared to England. So absolute advantage is very simple. Now the point is how to calculate comparative advantage. In that case, we have to see the opportunity cost, that if England, instead of producing cloth, only producing wine, then how much is the opportunity cost for that? You know, you're getting a point. It means 5 units of cloth will be equal to 4.54 units of wine. Then one unit of wine will be equal to how many cloths, or one unit of cloth will be equal to how many units of wine. We can calculate for any figure. So I have done it for that. Portuguese has absolute advantage over England in both cloth and wine that we have just seen. In order to calculate comparative advantage, we will compare England in one day can produce at a cost of $500, you know, 0.91 units of wine or 1 unit of cloth. How I have calculated it, just I will be telling you. 5 units of cloth is equal to 4.54 units of wine. So for 1 unit of cloth, how many units of wine? We can calculate 1 into 4.54 upon 5, that comes to 0.91 units of wine. It means if England is producing 1 unit of cloth, then they are sacrificing 0.91 units of wine. It means they can either produce 0.91 units of wine or they can produce 1 unit of cloth. Similarly, I can calculate for Portuguese also, that if they are producing 1.12, either they can produce 1.1261 units of wine or they can go over 1 unit of cloth. Now, the point is, which country should produce which? Now, it is very simple, you know. The point is, Portuguese should go for wine and England should go for cloth. We have just concluded here. Just see, 1.126 units of wine is equal to 1 unit of cloth for Portuguese. And if I compare here, 0.91 units of wine is equal to 1 unit of cloth. It means if Portuguese are producing cloth, they will be either producing 1 unit of cloth and losing 1.12161 units of wine. So it is better that Portuguese should go for wine, because they can produce more with the opportunity cost by not producing cloth. So it is better that Portuguese should produce wine, because they can produce 1.1261 units of wine in a day, and they can lose the opportunity of producing 1 unit of cloth. So England should produce cloth and Portuguese should produce wine. So this is a comparative advantage which I did. So let me show you something in the Google, that what I mean by comparative advantage and what I mean by absolute advantage. You know, absolute advantage is one nation can produce more output with the same resources. Comparative is one nation can produce a good at a lower opportunity cost than the other. So in comparative, we have to calculate, you know, the opportunity cost as compared to if I produce product X and as compared to product Y, then how much is the opportunity cost which is there, and then we can conclude that which product has which comparative advantage, because then only we can have economic welfare. So the point is, we want to enjoy the economic welfare, and for that we should know that which country should produce which thing, and for that we should be aware of absolute advantage and comparative advantage. Hope you have understood these case studies, with the help of which no doubt we will be doing with the practical problems and the, how to calculate the absolute and comparative advantage in coming days. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.